Hey guys, what is going on? CS Summit is over now. Champions are Liquid. Good to see someone else winning once in a while. And really, Liquid hadn't won a major or big kind of tournament until this one. So, best of five against Cloud9. Cloud9 had the map advantage straight into it coming from the upper bracket, but Liquid is still able to close it out, last map being Overpass. Naphfly has shown that he's very confident on Overpass. He plays this rotator position on the CT side. So you notice he's in the Heaven position. He's the one rotating over towards A if that is necessary. However, Elise has pushed through. So start off with here, the take comes in from Cloud9. Very standard kind of thing. Heaven's smoked off, just basically because the longer range, the weaker the Glocks are against the USP. Naf decides to jump out here. Why is this? Well, his team's already very committed here towards the A site. You'll see Twists is running away a little bit. If we play it a little bit more, you'll see Steel has got these positions, Twists also in this position, Nitro as we saw before. He's very pushed up at the barrels. So his team's already committed to this fight, so he wants to get in and help them. There's no point in him being locked out when he's already got three teammates fighting. May as well make it four, make the stack absolutely count. So he does the absolute right thing here in jumping out the balcony. And you'll see Nitro goes down, does get a little bit stuck. But after this, he just plays his headshot kind of angle. He can jiggle around a lot on this little bank here. And the whole time, they're all facing together. Him, Steel, or Steel's just, he's just fade away, I think maybe for a reload or something. But Twists, and they see they're all fighting together. There's no point one of you hiding or two of you hiding. You want to fight together, give the T's multiple targets to shoot at, and that's exactly what they do. Having four players on the site straight away, of course, gives them a huge advantage. Liquid does often like to play these three-man setup towards B, so often Naf is rotating to the A site. And there's always he's very aggressive about it, but he seems to be pretty smart about when he does it and always commits to good fights and good timings, and there's always a reason behind why he pushes in when he does. So start off with him here, Nitro and Liege get taken out on the A site. So it's now at 2v3, sorry, and Naf is now rotating in fast. One thing to notice when you are the rotator in from B, the fastest route is towards this position right here. Very standard kind of thing. And one thing that surprises me about a lot of pro teams is they never watch this angle right here. You see teams often do what Rush is doing now. They push into bank rather than cover their teammates. I mean, this is all good for after plant and all, but if you don't get the bomb down or someone rushes out the dumpster like Naf is about to do, things can end up very badly. And even if it's not pushing into the bank like this, even if it's someone just up on site with Taric, they often look towards bank, which always confuses me because the fast rotator is where Naf is about to come out. So Naf knows it's a 2v3. He knows something needs to happen here. They know they have toilets control. They have a couple of scouts. And we've all been in this situation. If you try and defuse this bomb now and you've got scouts or an AWP are particularly effective at this range, looking down the toilets, peeking you quickly, it's going to tag you up. You're not going to be able to defuse the bomb. So Naf knows he has to get something done ASAP. And that's exactly what he's going to do here. Rush, as I said, pushes in. So the bomb still goes down, but Naf is straight away able to get in. He kills the bomb plant and makes it a 2v2. Rush's position is still a problem as they're not clearing it out, as Steel is just coming in behind him, but it ends up not being a problem at all. Naf just continues the momentum through. Steel's going to push with him. If we watch here together, Rush decides to peek out. Naf gets another kill here, and they know the player's going to be back, as I said. The scouts are very effective at this range. Skadoodle does take out Steel, misses his shot, so Naf wins it. If Skadoodle hit that second shot, could have been very different there. But a couple of things about that round. Interesting that Rush pushes into bank. He leaves that open for Naf. I'd much prefer him just to sit around, even sit at the truck, or if he is going into bank, know that the timings of the map are likely to lead that the CTs are either going to want to, in this situation, he can just wait for two or three seconds, look here towards the dumpster if anyone tries to push out like Naf does. Then he knows straight away that then there might be someone coming up bank. Because you think about these fast rotates, you're going to hear all these sound cues. No one's going to be able to slow walk up from B, slow walk up and creep up to you behind the bank area. It's a little bit of a misplay from Rush, but actually a very common one that I've seen from a lot of pro players. Naf capitalizes, pushes out, gets three nice kills, just following his momentum through, and obviously wins in the round. Round 8 saw a 4-spy come out of Liquid. CZ's all round except for a Liege with a scout. So Naf and Nitro here decide to go in towards the connect area, a spot where your pistols are quite effective. In this particular round, Cloud9 go for some kind of B execute. So the call comes in as apply pressure towards short. So the trade comes in for Naf, very standard stuff on Stu, and right there he makes a very important decision. Instead of going for the gun, he decides to save the half a second, come up here and help his teammates on the B site. Now, if Steel and Twist and Steel, whatever, weren't here on the B site, weren't so committed in the water area, Naf goes and collects this gun, no problems. He wants the better rifle, AK is much better than the CZ, but instead he knows his players are applying pressure. Rush is blind here. Steel's also blind, but everyone's a bit blind. Twist is fighting, so he knows here these Cloud9 players are going to be very concentrated towards the water position. Automatic's looking at it. As we said, Rush is quite blind, and Skadoodle doesn't really have an angle here to look towards short. So Naf knows he can apply the pressure straight away, and that's what he does. He catches Rush off guard, and right now it becomes quite tricky for Automatic. Automatic wants to commit in here towards the water area, but now you see Skadoodle's forced to use a smoke. So time's gone down where Skidoodle doesn't have his gun out, and Naffit's applied a lot of pressure, which probably wouldn't have been there if he had gone and collected the AK. You'll see he's actually a little bit further into the tunnel. But he does collect it now. So now he has a 4v2 rather than a 4v3, possibly even worse if Automatic has time to push around and just kill the players in water because he has the better rifle. So Skidoodle has smoked him off, and I like this re-aggression right now. So they are smoked off, but the players in pit are still alive. Twist and Steel, despite they have a combined 28 HP, they're still being a nuisance. He knows they're going to have to deal with them pretty fast. His teammate in Elise, he's actually in the heaven to help out a bit. But straight away, there's no waiting around here. Automate gets the kill, and he's straight through here onto the site. And even though Twist gets the kill, it's great pressure again to try and catch these players trying to apply pressure. And he might get the last kill. He doesn't get the last kill, but you can see the pressure he's applying all the time. And honestly, his decision and his discipline to not go for that AK is actually quite impressive. And he's actually something that makes a significant difference going into the round. Again, in this one, Naff is the rotator, pushing into A as Elise gets traded. And he goes for a full committal once again. So he does this constant pattern of aggression, but there always seems to be a method behind it. So right now, the flash goes out. He knows it gives him a position to move, even though it was a T-sided flash. And the reason he's out here so aggressively is because of Nitro's position. Nitro's still in the toilet here. No one's checked him out. No one's been bothered to walk through here. Automatic obviously walked through the outside position. The other two players came out along. So Naff knows right now, if I can apply a bit of pressure here with 10 seconds left on the clock, Nitro gets a kill, I get a kill, we can shut this round right down, sees exactly what happens, and Automatic gets left in the worst position you never want to be left in your life. So there goes the kill straight away, and as this kill goes in, Nitro is also peeking out here, and he's going to catch off Rush, and there's two players down straight away. Automatic has no idea where to look. Is he going to fight the guy at truck in Naff, or is he going to fight the guy behind him? And there's nothing they can do. So Naff, again, relying on teammate positioning to decide when he's going to push through hyper-aggressive. And there seems to be a pattern for this whole thing. He does it very well. He always picks a good point when to push through, depending on his teammate's positioning. You saw with the CZ as well. This is something that's fundamental. It can be a difference between a good player and a great player, is deciding when to push through smokes, when to push into a site, when to retake, how to retake as a team. And this is something you can also consider here. Obviously, most of these clips, Naff was very aggressive, jumping out the site, trying to get in. But that's not always going to be the case. Sometimes if your teammates have all gone down, you've got a 3v3, you might want to just relax here. Just try and retake it again. But in these situations, you always had a man disadvantage or something. That's it, guys. A little bit more wordy in this one. So let me know what you think. A little bit less highlighting than normal. But of course, your feedback's always appreciated. If you like this kind of content, you're new, make sure to subscribe. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.